Let's say goodbye with a smile, dear, just for a while, dear, we must part. Don't let this parting upset you, I'll not forget you, sweetheart. We'll meet again, don't know where. Don't know when.
The 447 started out as a Royal Air Force Association in 1939 to 1945 during World War II. It was used as a training facility for the airmen that were going overseas. We did have 13, I believe, pilots during the training period pass away through training accidents. And they are buried at St. Paul's on Upper James there. We, as the RCAF, or Royal Canadian Air Force Association, we took over the building sometime later. I can't give you an exact date, but we took over and have been using the facility as a veterans club ever since. We purchased the building from Crown Assets Corporation in 1975. And we, as I say, leased the land through the city via trade port.
60s and 70s, it was really our heyday. We were all much younger and liked partying, and this place was just booming. We're all getting pretty old, and our executive were still members of 447 veterans, but it's very, very difficult. A lot of them don't drive at night, and memory is a big problem with older people, and then we started dying, and it's just every month there's some of us are dying off.
Well, most of the years were really good years. The rough times have come in the last few years because of various things we've had happen here. Basically, why we started the club is as a sort of a memorandum. Something to give memories to the people who didn't come here or come back from the war, and those who did come back could have some comradeship here, you know, enjoy each other's company. And there was a similarity in of experience and knowledge everyone enjoyed.
The relationship we have with the airport and trade port, we lease the land from trade port and have been leasing since 1975, I guess. Trade port is wanting us to vacate the land so that they can use it for, I've heard many different uses, such as a car rental agency. I've also heard a fuel depot, things like that. And they are pushing to get us out. So we're just, we're staying put as long as we can.
Basically, it's expensive, very expensive in the winter, it's very expensive in the summer, and when it does back off about this time of the year in the spring, as far as heating or air conditioning goes, then we deal with the rain. I'm going to say that summertime, you would be looking with the air conditioning going, the kitchen running, everything else, utilities, about $7,000 a month would be a rough guesstimate.
There's quite a few members that come up here, were born and raised in Hamilton, and they joined the Air Force in Hamilton. And for them to lose all this, they tell their children and their grandchildren, you know, all this stuff about the club and the war and everything. And today, the young people, they don't seem to care about this stuff. They're not interested.
That we just feel that it is a part of this part of the country, that it should remain there. So, you know, they're still doing what they can when they can. Unfortunately, too many of the members are lost now.
It's been very weird that, you know, the place closes and then, you know, the community really jumps in and, you know, the students from Mohawk, I've got students from McMaster working on the business plan, so it's great to have a younger generation in here taking interest.
This is the 447 Wing Benefit Dance and Silent Auction. We're here to support the 447 Wing and their endeavors to keep this wonderful heritage going.
Well, I think it'll lose a big chunk of its war history. I mean, Hamilton was, with this airport here, was very important to the war, and there was a lot of people trained here, people died during training here, and it would be a shame just to let that go unnoticed and unsaid. I'm glad that they got to have one last hurrah before this building goes, and I hope that they find a new building soon.
I'm an advertising student, and Nancy's my teacher. So we all got together and she was talking in PR class about saving the wing. So we all decided it would be cool to try and help out. So we organized the dance and the fundraiser and whatnot. As I was telling Alex, it's just really cool that, you know, a bunch of young people got together to help the older people. Like, the reason that I am, you know, we don't have to be fighting in a war or anything is because of the people who are here tonight. So it would be nice to give back and help them.
Tonight has been more than we could have imagined. I mean, it's much more than what I initially thought was going to be here tonight. I'm quite pleased with the turnout, very, very happy. We're still working on the location. We're still in talks with the city on that. We have been told we may have a piece of land off Homestead, which will give us some signage for the Highway 6 or Upper James now. Which will bring in the people as well.
What is this money going towards?
The money tonight will be going towards building the new building that we are looking to build. And that new building is a totally green building. It's a new company that is starting up, building homes. It has a very high efficiency rating, and we'll cut down on our costs for heating and air conditioning immensely.
We'd like to say we appreciate the fact that Mohawk has done this for us. It's significant, very significant. And we have, the group we've had out tonight reminds us of old times here, because it's a great group.
And people don't realize here what it's like for the hardship that some people have to gone through. We're seeing it now, what the people are doing in Bosnia and all them other countries over there now, and they're realizing what the hell these people have to go through. If you follow what I mean, that's the young people here, they've never seen any hardships.
I think it's disgusting. I mean, I think they should leave it. It is a heritage to the war. And I mean, there's so many young people today that haven't got a clue what it was all about.
They make a big fuss of the veterans. About every two or three years, they'll have some kind of a big dinner, and they wine us and dine us, such as they did two or three years ago. I can't remember exactly when it was. And there were so many dinners, you couldn't get to all of them. And then they dusted it off and took all the veterans out and made a big fuss. When that was over, they put us back in the cupboard, closed the door, and they forget about us.
Whenever we hear the word veteran, we automatically assume World War I, World War II. There are still veterans out there today.
Not very nice. Right. This is an extraordinary club. It has a lot of atmosphere. I've had people walk in here and look at it and say, I'm back in the 40s. There have been a lot of movie people up in Mount Hope in this at the airport who've come through here. And they've really ooh-nawed with the atmosphere in here and the way it's built. And I think the city, in a sense, is losing out, because this is an opportunity to keep something that's historic. And there are very, very few of any of these H clubs left.
We'll meet again, don't know where. Don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some.